The story of human evolution is not that simple. It is not just a linear development of us from a more ape-like feature to a human-like form. It's rather a parallel form of evolution, and with each developing stage, we see the emergence of a new species. Now, what is more interesting in this developing stage is the emergence of tool. Now, this particular tool has evolved with us. That means with every new stage of our development, we see that tool has become more and more complex. Now, the striking important thing about my study is that when I see the resemblance of the tools made by our ancestors with the tools made by the living non-human primates. And more interesting factor is this, that these particular activities is being reported from specific pockets of the globe. And my study is going to actually emphasize in one particular ecological zone, which will help us to understand why this global clustering of tool culture happens. With this, I introduce you to my study topic, which is exploring tool use by Nicobar long-tailed macaques in the Nicobar Islands of India and associated factors. So what do I study? I study the tool use behavior, and with tool use comes to tool culture. Now, how do I understand the tool culture? For this, I have to understand the learning models. Now, why do I understand the learning models? If I understand the learning models, it will help me to understand how the animals within the group share the knowledge between the members, which enables them to pass the knowledge from one generation to another. This, in turn, will help me to understand why the geographical clustering of tool use and tool culture happens. Now, following this, I'll take you to my methods section. So first important factor is the study site. Where do I conduct the study? So Nicobar Islands are among the excluded group of islands, and hence there is no influence of any other form of animal over the animals living in this particular region. Hence, any behavior which has come up into the life of the animals living in this particular island are innovative and specific to them only. Second is the study animal. Now, long-tailed macaques are among the 5 species out of 702 non-human primate species which have shown the potential of tool use. And since they are present in India, it makes it even more global important study area as well as study species to understand the emergence of tool use and tool culture. Third is the type of behavior which I collect. Now you have to understand, the type of behavior I collect is something which is only based on observational data, which means I collect qualitative data which are later again modified and turned into quantitative data to best suit the type of hypothesis I plan to test. Now with this, I take you to the next slide. Now let me take you to the most interesting slide of my presentation. This slide will actually show you how I conduct the research in my study area. Now all you know is that I have focused on tool use behavior, but you must also be sure how I differentiate between an object use and a tool use. I'll make it very simple for you to understand. Now let's take it this particular item. It's a pen used for writing. So I'm using a pen to write. It is an object use because the function and the morphology has been retained. Now when I use the same item to tie my hair to keep it in its position, it becomes a tool. Why? The function has changed. That's why. When I use the same pen, this mental is part, and I use the hollow part to drink water from a glass, it becomes a tool again. Why? Because the function as well as the morphology has changed. With this, let's peep into the mind of the monkey. In this particular video, you can see that the monkey is rolling a food over a surface. Now, we have come to know that the monkey has to consume the food. How it consumes the food? By rolling it against the surface. Why it does that? Because the surface of the food is very rough and it has to be smoothened before the oral consumption. So it has a target, it has come up with a solution, and then it selects the raw material. But what are the other behaviors in which you can understand the tool culture? The foraging behavior is one such example, and the video is related to foraging. But there is again play behavior, there is again aggressive behavior in which tool culture can be understood. Most interesting factor over here is that certain group of animals have shown this clustering of tool use, and my study is actually going to understand what factors are influencing it and how they're influencing it. For this, I can give you one example. Ecology is having a very strong influence and a different kind of influence on the tool culture. This can be seen in the long-tailed macaques present in Thailand and in India. In Thailand, they forage on oysters and they use stone tools, but in India, they forage on fruits and they do not use stone tools. How is ecology playing a key role into it? It's very simple to understand. In Thailand, the coastline areas, they have more rocks, but in India, the coastline areas is devoid of rocks. In short, they do not give the monkey the ample opportunity to forage on oysters, and hence the monkeys in India do not use stone tools. This is the striking difference between the long-tailed macaques present in Thailand and in India, but I'm yet to understand how the social and demographic factors influencing tool culture. With this, I come to the last slide, and these are the funding bodies which are funding my research, and I hope you like my PhD thesis topic, and thank you for being so patient.